Pipenv is a tool that creates and manages a virtual environment for your projects and adds or removes packages from your pipfile as you install or uninstall them. It also generates the Pipfile.lock, which we use to produce deterministic builds and create a snapshot of our working environment. Pipenv provides us with an easy method to set up a working environment. You no longer need to use pip and virtualenv separately, they work together. Before we start using pipenv, we will need to install it. I assume you have installed Python and pip on your machine. So open the terminal and run pip install --user pipenv and pip reinstall pipenv within your home directory. You might need to replace pip with pip3 depending on the Python version you have installed on your computer. You might want to add the user basis binary directory to your past environmental variable for your components. If you don't, you will receive command not found by running the pipenv command directly. To do that, on Windows, open the command prompt and run py-m site --user --site, and this will return the path to the user site packages directory. Replace site packages with scripts in this path to receive a string for adding to the path variable, and then run setx command to insert that string to the path variable. On macOS or Linux, open the terminal and run python-m site --user --base. Add bin to this path to receive a string for adding to your bash rc file. Edit bash rc file and then add an export statement to insert that string to the path variable. And finally, run this command to make the change take effect. To create a new virtual environment using a specific Python version, use the --python flag. Navigate to the directory containing your Python project and run pipenv-python 3.8.5, which is the installed version of Python on my computer. Alternatively, you can run pipenv-3 to initialize a Python 3 virtual environment, or pipenv-2 for Python 2. By running this, pipenv will create a new virtual environment for your project with the Python version you specified as the required Python version for this project, and it will tell me where I can find the newly created virtual environment. You might want to verify the Python version installed in your virtual environment. To do so, you first need to activate that virtual environment by running pipenv shell. We will then run python --version, and this will tell me the installed version of Python. You can also deactivate this shell using the exit command. Now you can install the third-party packages you need. To install a Python package for your project, use the install keyword. For example, here we are going to install request version 2.24. To install the latest version of a package, not a specific version, you could omit the version from this command. You can similarly remove this package by running pipenv uninstall requests. Let's say you also want to lint your code and you want to use pylint for doing this. You don't need pylint in production, so you can specify that this dependency is only for development using the --dev flag, and pipenv will add the pylint under dev packages within pipfile. This section separates dependencies needed only for development from ones needed for the code to work. To update a specific package or all the packages in your project's dependencies, you first need to find out whether there is any new release for the packages in your dependencies. Run pipenv update --outdated and pipenv will return a list of outdated packages. Now you can update all the packages by running pipenv update or pipenv update requests to update the request package only. Let's say you are ready to push your project to production. To do that, you need to lock your current working environment to ensure you will have the same production environment. Run pipenv lock. Now you are in the production environment and want to replicate the exact environment you had in development. Let me remove the current virtual environment to simulate this situation. I'm then going to install the last successful environment. Run pipenv install --ignore --pipfile and this tests pipenv to ignore the pipfile for installation and use what is in the pipfile.lock, and it will create the same environment as you had when you ran pipenv lock.